Last week, we worked on creating our own imaginative creature drawing. Once we drew the basic body in pencil, we traced it in permanent marker and then used the crayons to add implied texture throughout the drawing. Today, we will add the background and finish coloring with watercolor paints. The background of an art piece is the area or scenery behind the main object. Using crayon, create a background scene for your creature. It could represent more about its personality, where it lives, or just be an interesting environment. The final step is to watercolor paint your picture. Begin by waking up your paints with clean water. When you're ready to use the paint, gently swirl your brush to mix the water with the surface of the concentrated color. You'll need to continually add more water to the paint as you use it. You will know the consistency is correct if the color looks transparent or see-through, and there are no dark, sticky chunks as you paint. The paint should flow off of your brush onto the paper very smoothly. If it is not, it usually means you need to add more water. Each time you're ready to switch colors, dip your brush into the bottom of your water cup and press the bristles against the floor of the cup in order to clean the brush properly. As you remove the brush, remember to gently swipe along the top of the cup to remove the extra water and not tap the cup. This will keep your artwork neater because you won't get paint and water splashes on your work. You will notice as you paint that wherever you put the crayon, the paint will not fully cover. This resist technique happens because the crayon is made of wax. When you try to paint over it, the thinner watercolor paint slips off the waxy marks. You may also notice that if you paint an area and it touches another wet color, the two colors will mix. This works great if you want to blend your colors together. This could become a problem if you wanted to keep your colors separate. If you do not want your colors to mix, you will need to make sure that you let one color dry before you paint next to it with a new color. Continue painting until you fill all the white space of your picture.